G'day. So we're looking at why we need to cycle our aquaponic system, and I'll talk about what that actually means. People often build an aquaponic system, awesome, great job, and then put the fish in there and go, well, you know, fish are in dams and streams and rivers and the ocean, and they all survive, so they should be able to survive in the aquaponic system. We forget, humans forget, that everything in life is an ecosystem. So we have the river ecosystems and the ocean ecosystems and the rainforest ecosystems, and every continent on this planet has an ecosystem, and that is designed to have things that will get rid of or decompose the waste within that ecosystem. So when we make something, so a man-made pond, a man-made wetland, a man-made ecosystem, we have to put that bacteria that's in every other ecosystem into our aquaponics ecosystem to get it to then start working as its own ecosystem. So if you put fish in there without that bacteria that will get rid of their waste, the fish are going to end up dying. Now, it might take 2 days, it might take less than that, depending on the number you put in there. It might take, if there's small, tiny little fish in a really big tank, it might take a few weeks, but it will happen. So what we do is we cycle our system. I say cycle our system because we need to colonize our aquaponic system, because it's a man-made ecosystem. We're colonizing it with the natural bacteria that's within every other ecosystem. So that's what we're needing to do. So when we put fish into a pond, the pond already has that bacteria. It develops, and the bacteria can take anywhere between, you know, 3 weeks to 3 months to colonize whatever we're wanting to do. So it depends on our climate as to how long it will take. And we can help that along as well. But when people put fish into a pond, that already has a natural ecosystem there. So the bacteria that converts their fish waste, the ammonia, into fertiliser for the plants or the water plants or the algae, it's already there. The same with the rivers and the creeks and the oceans. It has an established ecosystem to be able to deal with all of that. Whereas when we've got our man-made smaller system, we have to colonise that. So that's why we need to colonise our aquaponic system and cycle it to get that bacteria happening. So cycling means we're colonising it with bacteria. There's two types of bacteria we need, Nitrosomonas and Nitrobacter. And hop into the next video and I'll talk about what they are and what they do. Alrighty, so how do we cycle our system and what does that actually mean? It means we're colonising our aquaponic system, which is a man-made ecosystem. We're colonising that with nitrifying bacteria. And that's my aquaponic system, that's why I'm pointing in that direction. We're colonising it with bacteria that is going to convert the fish waste, so the ammonia from the fish waste, not their solid waste, just the ammonia which comes out of their gills and their urine. We're converting that from ammonia into a usable fertiliser that the veggies then take up. How do we know that this is happening and how does it work? Well, we need our freshwater master test kit. It has the tests that we need. So we're needing to colonise, as I keep using the word, colonising bacteria. So we're adding bacteria. Now, bacteria is in every ecosystem, every environment in the planet. Isn't it awesome? It's everywhere. It can naturally colonize within your aquaponic system, but that can take, depending on your climate, anywhere from 3 weeks to 3 months. Okay? If you're wanting to speed it along, there are ways in which you can do that. We can add bacteria, and this is just one type of bacteria from any aquarium store will have it. It's the same bacteria for aquariums, same bacteria for aquaculture, it's the same bacteria that's in nature. Okay, when we get it from an aquarium shop that's, say, in a container like this, this is spores, of the spores of the bacteria, so as soon as this connects with water, they'll start to grow and reproduce. You can get live bacteria, that's going to happen a little bit quicker. And we'll talk about how you can seed your bacteria with current bacteria as well. But first off, there's two bacteria that we need to get. So Nitrosomonas, that converts ammonia into nitrite, okay? And we have the test kits that show you ammonia, nitrite. Nitrobacter converts the nitrite into nitrate. Nitrate is the fertilizer that our plants use. So I'm going back, ammonia is highly toxic for fish, and that it's their waste, they produce it, and it needs to be converted, it needs to be removed from their ecosystem, otherwise it can kill them very, very quickly and easily. The first bacteria, nitrosomona, that converts that into nitrite. Nitrite is still very toxic for fish. Okay, they can die horrible deaths with having nitrite present in their system. So the second bacteria, nitrobacter, is then within the system, and it converts that waste, the nitrite, into nitrate. Two bacteria converts ammonia into nitrite, the second one into nitrate. The nitrate is what's then absorbed by our veggies. They are then filtering the water for our fish. No more ammonia, no more nitrite, and the nitrate is being absorbed and used by our veggies, and the water is then cleaned for the fish. And a nice system that we have happening. So how do we know that it's working? And this is where our test kit comes into play. When we start adding ammonia, and we want to do this without fish, it's called a fishless cycling. Adding something that's, you know, this is a, what is this? It is a fish emulsion, it's organic. This one's Charlie Carpenter we have in Australia. People use all different forms of ammonia, make sure it is pure ammonia, no other additives or anything like that. It will do more harm than good. By adding that and by adding a continuous source of that, so simulating what your fish would be doing, your fish are constantly breathing, okay, constantly peeing, so there's constant ammonia in the system. So you're needing to simulate that by adding a small amount, and always go small amounts first, of the ammonia source. And once you start getting, with your test kit, so going through testing and then we're looking at ammonia, once we start seeing we have ammonia present, that's awesome, that's simulating the fish environment. We're wanting to see when we have the next bacteria happening, right? We cannot get any bacteria without an ammonia source. We must have ammonia, so you must continue to do and add ammonia. When we know that we've got the first bacteria happening is when we start getting nitrite. But here's the thing. This is why we don't want to have our fish present, because I got a little impatient, and this is what happened. People get impatient with their ammonia source. I'm not getting nitrite readings. I'm not getting nitrite readings. I don't have bacteria. We add more and more and more. Now, that looks black, but it is such a dark green that it doesn't even show up on my thing here. 8 parts per million. That will kill fish within as soon as it touches them. Anything more than... When you start getting ammonia, bad news. I currently have 0.25 in my aquaponics system, and that's not awesome, but I've just fed them, so it's understandable. But because we get these spikes of the ammonia and the nitrite, that's why we don't want to have our fish in the aquaponics system. So, big spike of ammonia, you'll then end up getting nitrite. And this is at a very small level still, but that is actually enough to kill your fish. So that would be 0.5, possibly 0.1, one part per million. But that is enough to kill the fish. And this, when you're cycling, will go right down to the deep purple. That will kill your fish. That's why we don't want the fish. But having the nitrite showing up shows us that we have nitrosomona there, because it's converting ammonia into nitrite. So we know that we've got nitrosomona present in our system, and it's needing to reproduce and really get cracking and colonise and reproduce and get everything happening so it can build up a good colony of bacteria within your system. So we're then waiting for the second bacteria, Nitrobacter, to come in and show us that it's here. So this is only 20 parts per million, but then it's perfectly okay for the fish. The fish can tolerate up to about 80 parts per million, but this is what we need present for our veggies. So ideally we're having between 10 parts per million and 40 parts per million, but it will fluctuate. But as soon as I have nitrate in the system, I know I've got nitrobacter. But I will still have that spike of nitrite, and this will spike really, really high. So as soon as you have nitrate present, add a couple of plants, and that will start to ease off that spike of nitrite, getting it safe for fish. So here's the thing, and here's something that people mess up a fair bit. You've got ammonia and it's spiked. You might have all three readings at once. It depends on how you're doing your system and how it's working. You might have the ammonia goes back up to zero, which is awesome. That's what you want. But you still have nitrite present, and people get excited going, got nitrite, I've got nitrate, it's cycled. Yay, I've got everything present. Your system is not cycled until you have zero ammonia or 0.25. That's what we call a trace amount. Zero nitrite and nitrate present. So in testing my aquaponics water this morning, I have, as I said, that 0.25, and this has been cycled for ages, so this is ongoing water quality now. It's showing that I've just fed the fish, so there's trace amounts of ammonia at 0.25. There is zero nitrite, and I have nitrate present within the system. I can only have nitrate present if I've got both bacteria, both nitrous ammonia and nitrobacter. It's the only way I can have nitrate in the system. Nitrobacter will not convert ammonia. It will only convert the nitrite. So this is how we know. Your system is cycled when you're at zero or 0.25 of ammonia and zero nitrite with nitrate present. That is when it is cycled. So I mentioned before, this is what we really don't want. This will kill your fish. We get impatient. So I was wanting to do an example because all of my water quality everywhere is not showing bad results. So I was simulating, and I'll show you at the end of this, I'll add on that video of me in the bucket and how it was disastrous. So here's the thing. If you're wanting to add bacteria from someone else's aquaponics system, how can you do that? How can you colonise without, say, buying some? If so, you've got a mate. Well, here's the awesome part. Go to their aquaponics system. This is where your bacteria lives, within the gravel. That's the whole point of what we've got happening here. This is where my bacteria is living. So I need to get a handful of that, and that will start to colonise, but it will take time. Or if the person's like me and they have extra filtration, bear with me, extra filtration in here. This is called a coldness one. You can also use bio balls and everything like that. That is also where we can colonise our bacteria. So I can put some of that filter media, just like if I got it from my aquarium, I can put that in my aquaponics system and start it off that way. How awesome is that? So that is how we cycle our system and why we cycle our system. Hope you enjoyed that. Leave us any comments, ask questions. Love answering. See you next time.